Right, so here we're actually flip and go. All right, I'm gonna be trying something out. I'm actually gonna be trying to stream to YouTube this time to see how that actually works. I did pick up a game from a friendly face over at the Dota 2 casted forums called Zyls TV. Not entirely positive on how to pronounce that. XYLS TV. He promised us a short, very action-packed game, so that is this guy exactly what I'm gonna be expecting to try to test this out because I don't actually know if this is gonna work or not. So, yeah, let's get this show on the road, shall we? Generally, what's gonna happen is that basically I'm gonna be streaming some Dota, seeing how it works, and then I'm gonna maybe streaming something later on down the line. I'm not entirely
Witch
positive.
Doctor.
I'm still trying to mess around with some of the settings here. I know the screen is constantly freezing, and you can see my chat windows and such, but right now I'm just trying to figure everything out. Alright, it doesn't have a YouTube chat box incorporated. Fair enough. Never mind that though.
Spirit Breaker.
We're just gonna go ahead and have a Witch Doctor, a Death Prophet, and a Spirit Breaker. So, that's a thing.
Life's
Apparently. Sorry for the poor start, man. I'm
Shadow
very, very sorry for the poor start. I'm just. When I'm trying to be technical and try to be clever at the same time, it usually doesn't work out. And Direcide, they apparently can't decide on their heroes here. And, yeah, they just want Dire to immediately surrender. Five core lineup, they fucking won.
Prepare for battle!
There's a good chance they might. just saying, I haven't seen the replay itself, but then again, if this lineup can farm, it's gonna be killer. Like, it's gonna absolutely wreck face. I don't know how they're gonna get any vision onto the map, but then again, if this is as low level as a pub as I think it is, they might just survive it.
Yeah, it's about time.
But yeah, regardless, we do have the cores coming in from the Dire side as well. We've got the Phantom Assassin, possibly going on the mid lane. Sure as hell looks like it. We got the Juggernaut currently. Dreamcatcher carry. This is a weird build, Juggernaut. This is not how you build Juggernaut, by the way. He doesn't need that much mana regen. You just need to be careful with your Blade Fury. Unless he's going to be using the Blade Fury to farm, that's not how you build Juggernaut. Phantom Assassin's a bit more standard. You have the Stout Shield Tango and the Slippers of Agility. Witch Doctor, he went for the Null Talisman, Iron Branch, and Iron Branch. So no wards on either side. And looks like the Pudge is going to be taking the top rune, while the Gyrocopter is going to be taking the bottom. This is going to be absolute chaos. Because both teams seem to be building weird. Death Prophet going for a Soaring first. Actually landing out two Tangos to Shadow Fiend here, so he can have a good mid. Top lane, we've got the Pudgy Boy. Now going up against Banana Molester on the Phantom Assassin. God damn it, these names. I would love to get to introduce everybody, but I'm too scared that I'm going to miss anything. It looks like I was always going to miss First Blood there, unless they decide to give up Chase right at the very end. So yeah, Ravenat? Can't even tell. It's going to be on Yapuchi. Lemonade is going to be on the Spirit Breaker. Got Squidward's Tentacles on the Gyrocopter. They're on a bottom lane, level 0-0-0-0 on the Death Prophet. Got solo offlane Juggernaut. And, yeah, he's going to be picked up by, of course, Dreamcatcher, as mentioned before. Witch Doctor now going up against Spirit Breaker. Spirit Breaker doing quite a nasty amount of damage. But now maybe the turnaround, the bash on the Lifestealer. Hook is just going to split the racket completely. This could be a big pickup if the Pudge Hook can come off cooldown. If they can get him underneath the tower, it could actually be going the other way around. Now the Spirit Breaker is the one in trouble. Pudge, he's got a hook in about 2 seconds. He needs to find someone. And is he gonna? He could turn it, misses the hook from very, very close range. And now he's gonna end up killing himself. First Blood is gonna be going on the Spirit Breaker, but what about the Pudge? He's taken down from the Malphus. This could cost him his life, and it will. Witch Doctor with the second pickup there, and Direcide off to a good start. Storm Spirit gonna be the last pickup, gonna be hitting the middle lane here. He's got two last hits. And apparently, Spirit Breaker decided that he wanted to middle lane. This is something beyond weird. I don't think I can do any kind of pot or good analysis of this game because this is just strange. Yeah. Shadow Fiend. Yeah, okay. Anyway, alright. Death Prophet. Gonna be harassing down Storm Spirit just a teeny tiny bit. I'm gonna be trying to do what she can, or yeah, she can, to bring down the Storm Spirit to try to break him. But yeah, these lanes don't really make a whole lot of sense. Of course, you do have the solo lane Juggernaut, which up against a solo lane Gyrocopter would be bad. Up against a Death Prophet as well, it's gonna be terrible. I don't know. I'm trying to analyze this. This is just pure chaos. You got dual lane on mid. Shadow Fiend is trying to get Spirit Breaker out of his lane, and looks like he succeeded. Whereas Pudge is solo top laning for now, and Witch Doctor and Phantom Assassin are doing nothing about it. Lifesteal in the jungle, there's something that's somewhat normal. His skill build is as well. It's got Stout Shield and Quelling Blade too, so it's somewhat normal. But, wow. Now Pudge coming in. Does he look for a hook? Doesn't look like it for now. Phantom Assassin just blinking around here. So yeah, 2 kills in 3 minutes. Right now it's not entirely crazy. Well, it technically is, because Spirit Breaker is just gonna get a kill onto the Lifestealer here. 17% indeed. The 1700% Bastions. 17% every time. Shadow Fiend. Messing around with the Storm Spirit. Storm Spirit should actually win this lane, but because he joined so late, he might not. Pudge is going to go down and up in the top lane. Now Witch Doctor might die as well. Wow, we already got almost 6 kills. Lifestealer is going to be coming in, saving his Witch Doctor buddy, but can he hold up? Can he stack up to the damage? Yes, he can. And that'll cost the end of Spirit Breaker. That'll be the end of him as they chase him into the woods. He has no way of getting out, and one last swipe with those claws from Lifestealer will end him. 4 minutes in. We've already got 6 kills. On the mid lane, looks like Death Prophet is looking for a kill. This is more like Overthrow than anything else. Overthrow with 2 teams. This is nuts. Like, really. Yeah, top lane, eliminate. He's got a charge available. He could go on somebody. He's actually chosen to go for two points in a greater bash, even though it scales like crap. There you go, sees the Lifestealer, finds it, he needs a bash, there goes the bash. Second one, nope, not gonna be a bash. Third one, neither. But he's just taken down from the Orb of Venom. Not by much though. There's the last one, Spirit Breaker finding the kill. And now Pudgy is actually going on to the PA, will be finding that kill as well, so 4-4-4 so far. Witch Doctor could now be in trouble, in comes the charge, the bash as well, the immediate bash. Has a chance of getting another one, no bash just yet. Those 17% might actually be real after all. Still trying, Witch Doctor is slightly faster, and there's no charge for him. Now Lifesteal is coming back in, they could try to turn this. Out goes the open wounds. And just gonna be ripping through the Spirit Breaker completely. Bye-bye, Spirit Breaker. It's gonna be 5-4 in 5 minutes. I love the fact that... Oh, hold on. There's a Shadow Fiend. I was gonna say that I love the fact that the Shadow Fiend is trying to farm. But no, he's not. He's just gonna get killed by the Witch Doctor. This is an insane game already. God damn it. Lifestealer. Oh, hold on. Stuff happening on the middle lane. Storm Spirit is just gonna get cleaned up by the Spirit Breaker. This is one crazy game. I'm trying to sit here and analyze this, but it's just not happening. Juggernaut has an Omni Slash. If he kills this creep, he could jump them. Should probably do that. 3 swipes. It should be enough to bring down the Death Prophet. I'm not so eager to go. Silence is coming out, Crypt Swarm as well, so probably should be holding back here. Pudge gonna be finding the hook onto the Templars or Phantom Assassin. Oh, the charge is on, she's dead. She's dead for certain. But that was actually a good hook, dropping her really, really low, and kaboom. This is dumb. Like, I'm sorry, but this is just dumb levels of kills. This is weird. This is not your average pup game. 6 for 6 in 6 minutes. And now Lifestealer going up against the Bash Lord himself. He's not finding anybody. In comes the Pudge Hook. He's going to be cleaning up the Lifestealer. Another kill for the Pudge. And these are just so aggressive. He's just going to keep charging all the way through. Pudge can't really help him. He has no mana for a hook. And bye-bye will be the Spirit Breaker. He'll end up possibly, yep, going down. Not happening. Witch Doctor says no in Amalfis. Buyback from Spirit Breaker. He wants to help out his Pudge buddy, but But there's nothing that Pudge can do. Got denied by the neutrals. Easy denies. And yeah, Spirit Breaker's on the charging path again. He's just gonna go straight up for this top lane. Lemonade. He's trying to charge. What is he gonna connect with? There's Death Prophet up there as well. It's gonna cancel right as he gets up there. Shadow Fiend actually dying down in the middle lane as Lifesteal rotated. It's impossible to keep up with all these kills. Bottom lane as well. We're gonna be having an engagement. Oh, Juggernaut juking his way out of all that damage and will be finding the kill on the Gyrocopter. That should be his first death as far as I know. Top lane, we already got a fight going again. Witch Doctor is gonna eat a Crypt Swarm to the face. He does have a... he has the ward, he has the Death Ward. Look at it go, almost finishing up the Death Prophet. And actually will. That's gonna be one kill for the Witch Doctor and one for the Phantom Assassin. Bottom lane, we might have an engagement again. Pudge, he's trying to go up against the Juggernaut. He has enough mana for the Dismember. That could kill him. Just gonna eat through and munch through the Juggernaut. And then out goes the ward. He actually hooks a creep. And is gonna get the kill though with the sheer rot. We had another kill elsewhere on the map, I think. No, I don't. Okay, we didn't. I'm still trying to keep up with this. This is just going too fast. Top lane, Phantom Assassin. It is a nice Pudge. It is a very nice Pudge. He's got three kills. He's 3-4-3. Now looking for a Lifestealer. I don't know why he's in so deep. He's got to know they're aggressive. He's got to dismember if he wants it. Not going to commit it just yet. Now locks him in place. Turns on the Rot. Decides that that's probably not the best idea. Spirit Breaker in for the 8. In comes the Nether Strike. And bye-bye Ghost. Oh my god, the Nykes. The Lifestealer. That Crypt Swarm saving the Pudge's life. 11 for 11 at 9 minutes. This is more of a kill fest than anything else. And I love the fact that Witch Doctor has basically a better KDA than his last one. Bottom lane, we got another engagement. The ulti has come out from the Death Prophet, but will it come out from the Gyro? They need to find this Juggernaut. Not going to happen just yet. I think they would have at least done some. Is there a charge available? He was teasing them. He's still sitting back at Fountain. Gyrocopter taking that bottom tower. And now the Juggernaut unleashing the Battle Fury. Going to be cleaning up the Gyro just as he pops the rockets. And that's one way of counting him out. Now Death Prophet might be the one in trouble. Storm Spirit heading straight for her. Vortex into there is actually a regen rune. He's got to cancel that. He does before it heals enough up. And in comes the charge as well. He needs to find her quickly. He needs to get that kill very, very fast. And Juggernaut with the Omni Slash will be finishing it up. And if Spirit Breaker commits, he could die. So even though that's a Storm Spirit, it's still a Juggernaut right next. They're now going to be going for the Blade Fury. He's got an SF joining him, this Spirit Breaker. And they might find, yes, they will possibly find the Storm Spirit. He's ticking down. They will find the kill. Spirit Breaker should be getting out alive. There's still a Rec Room available. Another Raze missing them both. But in comes Gyrocopter as well. If they get this kill. Oh, the Jukes. The Jukes are for real. He's actually outdoing them. He's juking. He's going to make it out. About the same speed. Except for Gyro, who's slightly faster. In comes Lifestealer. I think he wants to try to turn things. Up in the top lane here, we have a crit onto the Death Prophet. She's going to end up going down. Pudge from the Mist Hook. And this is just insane. Insanity itself. 12-14. In 11 minutes. I am impressed. Shadow Fiend. Slowly chilling with the Storm Spirit here on mid. Top lane. The Pudge has rotated around. They got the charge on Witch Doctor. They need to find somebody. Oh, he hooks. God damn it. He hooks the Spirit Breaker. Oh my. Oh man. That is so unfortunate. And now the Pudge is dead. Oh, I feel bad for the guy. I really feel bad. All seriousness has gone out of this cast. God damn it. What a game. God damn it. Death Prophet, the only one defending top lane for now. They got the charge coming in as well. That might, yes, that is definitely going to connect on the Phantom Assassin. But what is it going to do for her?
Oh, look at it.
Oh, the stun from the Witch Doctor. Now the turnaround. The Malphite is on. He gets the Nether Blast. And now Death Prophet coming in. The Phantom Assassin is down, but so is the Spirit Breaker. And now it's only the Death Prophet. Not enough spirits in the entire world is going to keep you alive. And Shadow Fiend was off the back the hook from Pudge. Finds the Witch Doctor, but he might live. He might actually survive it. He will. The Omni Slash, the triple kill from the Juggernaut. And now it's all onto the Shadow Fiend. There is no Death Ward, but there is another Malphite and a Rec Room as well. But the kill from the Lifestealer. He pops inside a creep. The Infest. Helping tremendously and actually managing to spare him some of the damage. TP's coming in, double TP's. It's gonna be the Spirit Breaker. Going for the Lifestealer. He doesn't have anything to counter this out. He's got the Rage. He could pop it. That would speed him up a bit. He still doesn't have boots. Crypt Swarm will not be connecting, so he should be walking home fine. But man oh man, 13 to 19. Charge for the middle lane. Want to be following the Spirit Breaker. Figuring out what his intended target is. He's going to be going for the connect on the Phantom Assassin. And she might be dead. There is no Nether Blast just yet. She's got to go for some lucky crit. But just doesn't find him. 2 seconds on the Nether Blast. But now the Spirit Breaker is in trouble. Going to try to go for it. Yes, we'll find the Nether Blast. And we'll find the kill. But there is a Lifestealer. The charge away though will save him. And they could actually try to turn. There's the Shadow Fiend with the Yule Scepter. He doesn't have a Rec Room to come it up with, but he does have a double raise. Or two-man raise. Find the Storm Spirit. What else can they get their hands on? Juggernaut is going to be trying to get his ass out of there. The Shadow Fiend will be picking up the Lifestealer, who may be getting a bit over-enthusiastic. Just a tiny, whiny bit. Poke from Pudge, barely off the mark. And middle lane, the Squidward, the Gyrocopter is going to be pushing that lane. And I want to see the net worth for this. I want to see how the net worth is swinging. It's practically back down to zero. This is insane. Like, 82 last hits in 14 minutes. That's very respectable. But when you got 2-3-3, or 2-3-2, that's your Shadow Fiend. Well, something is going on, definitely. And when your Storm Spirit on the Dire side is practically the lowest net worth hero, something else is happening, and that's your Storm Spirit is getting owned in a lane he actually shouldn't. Charging onto the Witch Doctor. Mind you, he's got 7 kills, he's actually quite farmed, but the double damage Shadow Fiend out goes to Death Ward though, will be connecting the Lucky Casket Bounce, not even lucky, very, very skilled. Pudge will find the Witch Doctor and will commit suicide. So we'll find the even trade, and now Spirit Breaker is going to try to turn that trade into their favor. Finds the PA. Does he have a charge out? 6 seconds. He's going for the TP. They don't have anything to cancel it. He'll make it.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Wow.
Radiant
2 for 2. Radiant coming out slightly on top there. But not by much. I'm sorry to say it, Bar, but that was not super Dyer's fast hands. But this is insane, like.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
This right here Radiant's is like dumb levels of insanity. My Radiant's god.
Dyer's bottom tower is taking a beating.
Oh, you think so? You think it's taking a beating?
Here I am.
Bottom lane. The charge in onto the Storm Spirit. He's been controlled so well this game. Phantom Assassin. I was about to say Shadow Fiend. He's going for the pickup now on. Oh, the Pudge hook missing. But the Electric Vortex will actually save the life now. The Phantom Assassin recharge and counter initiation from the Spirit Breaker. They find one. They maybe find two. Juggernaut. He doesn't have enough mana for the ulti. It's just not enough to tear from. He's so close though. He's got to persevere and slowly regenning up. It's going to be about 10 seconds before he can get it. Charge right back in. He's way too low for this. Going underneath the tower. We'll be taking tower hits as well. One lucky crit. And we'll actually be finding the kill. Now the Gyro ult. We'll be slowing Juggernaut somewhat down. Spirit Breaker should be fine. He's TPing out of there. And he's going to be good. And back in the middle lane. The Witch Doctor will actually get destroyed. Actually, that was the top lane. Back down on mid or close to the secret shop at least. We might actually see a bit of a team wipe here. As Lifestealer just can't handle the damage of the Gyrocopter. They find him as well. Storm Spirit just died before that. He's now going to be sipping in. Finds nobody. Doesn't get the Vortex off. Now silenced up. They don't have anything to work. Yes, they do. They have the charge. The dire side, they're just going in single file. The Storm Spirit has practically got nothing to follow up with. He's got no damage whatsoever. And he will now be charged by the Spirit Breaker and will be broken. Out goes the Death Prophet ult. There is no Nether Blast available. Phantom Assassin. Taking the last couple of spirits to the face, but not going to be cleaning it up. And I'll actually push with these spirits. Just to have a little sense here, I'll just push this tower with them. Like, it'll be easy money right there. Pudgy boy. Oh, hold on. The charge. Spirit Breaker. Nether Blast is going to be connecting onto the Witch Doctor. He can pop the casket, but just too much damage from the Mask of Madness. Hook from the Pudge. Gonna be off the buck. 25 to 21 on 18 minutes. Regeneration. This is like the Blink Dagger from the Shadow Fiend. He's going Blink Yule's build. He's trying to try to work that Rec Room, but that does require him to farm. He's not quite ready for it yet. Spirit Breaker once again with a charge onto the Lifestealer. He needs a bash. He's not going to find it. Now Lifestealer's trying to turn things here. There goes the bash. That's one. Where's the second one? Shadow Fiend coming in to help. In comes the Phantom Assassin as well. The Yule's up. No combo with Rec Room just yet. He doesn't have enough souls. Now he does. He blows up the Shadow or the Phantom Assassin. And now off on two fronts here. The Death Ward will go. And the Witch Doctor will be finding the Spirit Breaker. Juggernaut ended up going down as well. Now might be the turn of the Storm Spirit. Shadow Fiend just casually strolling after. He has got a blink. Not going to be committing it though. But yeah, Witch Doctor. He's doing a tremendous job. He's always got a blink dagger. Just screw the Aghanim Scepter. I want a blink dagger. And screw the second point into my ult. That does absolutely nothing apparently. It's not like those 30 damage counted at all. But wow, insane game. Insane game. Death Prophet. With the Soul Ring. Not much more than that though, except for Yules. Charging, that's the Witch Doctor right there. And you want to look at that bash go. He hasn't connected any yet. Just going to be munching through him. Doesn't even need the bash. Bash is overrated, everybody. And he's actually... Oh, he's going Shadow Blade Cow. This is the proper Chaos Cow. Charging again. Got so much vision around the map right now. He's going for the Juggernaut. He doesn't have an Omni Slash. Is he quick enough on the Q? Yes, he is. Storm Spirit. Or Shadow Fiend, Yulesing himself up. He should probably use the Storm Spirit. And he might get cleaned up. Yes, he will. There goes the Rec Room. But with no damage sitting in that whatsoever. Bottom lane. Death Prophet gonna try to munch through this tower. It looks like she might be successful. But when is the backup gonna arrive? The Omni Slash, 6 seconds. Lifestealer is just gonna try to pull out of the lane. And now she's gotta go. She's gotta try for the TP. Is she gonna make it? Yes, she is. 20 minutes in. 29 to 24. I have not seen this kill heavy of a game in a long time. This is insane. Gyrocopter. Actually trying to get stuff done. Actually trying to farm. Charging from the Spirit Breaker, finds the Witch Doctor, gonna be having that first bash right there. Storm Spirit just sipping around, hooking from the Pudge, canceling the Witch Doctor, but the Juggernaut Omni Slash, he's now in trouble though. The Rec Room will rip and gonna almost kill him off completely. It actually will. It's reinitiation from the Storm Spirit. He's got a Lifestealer to back him up, but not for long. This Gyro is fat, he is farmed, and they will get the kill. That's a full team wave. 21 minutes, 34 to 25. What a team wipe. Impressive stuff, and what a Rec Room. What a Rec Room. Headdress, Buckler. It's going to be turning into a mech as well. Mech Yule Shadow Fiend is now reality. Urn. Done as well for the Spirit Breaker. He's going to be finding a lot of charges on that. They could actually go for the high ground, but they elect not to. They can't really... Well, they can't really push efficiently without the exorcism from the Death Prophet, so... I don't know if it's intentional that they're not going for it, but, yeah. A lot of these things actually happen at random, and Storm Spirit just going to do the sensible thing immediately right off the bat, and that's waste all of his mana with his Ball Lightning. Charging from Spirit Breaker. This is risky, but it might pay off. High risk, high reward. He's gonna YOLO it. Nope, he's not. Okay. Popping off right at the last second, but it's a good way. It's a good form of transportation. Bell of Strength on the Lifestealer. I'm not really sure what it's gonna do. Oh, hold on. Spirit Breaker right there, finding another Witch Doctor. Bottom lane, the push is imminent. That tower is gonna fall right there. Dire structures are fortified. Fortification on the Dire side. What the push actually have? He's got a Blink Dagger, that's about it. That's all, that's enough. Easy kill there. Shadow Fiend is gonna survive. The Juggernaut deny. But I don't know if it matters at this point. I would love to see the graphs here. I mean, 10k I had at 23 minutes. This is like dumb. Oh, the hook onto the high ground. He actually walks right back off it, but I don't think he's gonna survive though. He does have an Omni Slash, but the damage. There goes the Blade Fury, but he might get picked up. No, he won't. He'll actually survive. Storm Spirit is gonna be just as lucky. My god, how did he make it out of that? Well, I actually know how. He popped the Blade Fury, and instead of trying to chase the Death Prophet decided to go for a Crypt Swarm, which slowed her down too much. Pudge. He's got a hook available. Charging from Spirit Breaker all the way back from Fountain. He can find one. He can try to go for the hook. Sultan. He's gonna try for it and miss it. Didn't have the vision. Now gonna be blinking up. Just immediately dismembering the Witch Doctor. And out goes the Death Ward though. But I don't think it's gonna matter. It's not gonna finish. And now the Spirit Breaker is getting Omni Slash left, right, and center. Storm Spirit finding the Pudgy at the last second. But Shadow Fiend, I don't know how he's gonna get out of this. Self Yules. He's got a Blink available. There it goes. Death Prophet. They could set up for a nice little initiation with the Rec Room. He's gonna let it rip and gonna kill off the Phantom Assassin and the Juggernaut, and now the Lifestealer might as well just go as well. He's gonna end up going down for sure. What an ulti from the Shadow Fiend. Triple kill for him. That was a buyback from the Juggernaut right there. He could end up going down a second time. There it goes, and oh my god, easy kill. Easy ultra kill for the Shadow Fiend.
Dire's top tower's just died. Yeah.
Oh, very, very impressive.
I heard that tower had kids.
And here we go. Death Prophet. They go for the tier 3, and they're actually going to be able to take him somewhat uncontested. 15 grand, they're ahead. 41 to 27. Jumping from the Storm Spirit. Actually hopping right back out. Shadow Fiend is going to get Vortexed. Out goes the cooldown though. Gyrocopter joining the fight, and he does way too much damage for anybody to handle. Shadow Fiend is now godlike. Witch Doctor is going to end up getting cleaned up completely. Double kill for the Gyro as well. And I don't think this game is due for long anymore.
Because
god damn it, they've been wrecking face. Lifestealer can't even finish off the Death Prophet. The Bloodstone is just too much. And they're pushing in mid lane as well. The Spirit Breaker arriving with a big ass creep wave. Gyrocopter getting the SNY. He's also now too tanky for anybody to take on. Oh, the jump in almost into the fountain there. It's going to be connecting with the Shadow Blade. Mid lane, they could actually finish it up, but they're just waiting. They're trying to fountain farm here. Phantom Assassin jumps in, self-fuels, no Rec Room just yet, but now gonna be landing in RIP, gets an immediate triple kill. Bye-bye Lifestealer, bye-bye PA, bye-bye Juggernaut. The double Rec Room my god, what a hefty amount of damage. That was incredible. BOTs, Shadow Fiend, right back in the fray here. Hook out of the fountain from the Pudge, and this is just fountain farming at its finest. 48 to 28. I was promised crazy, and damn well that's what I got. But yeah, I don't think this game is due for much longer. Spirit Breaker, finishing up the melee racks. It could be sub 20 minute megas. Hook, gotta miss.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's middle barracks.
But the middle racks have fallen. And now, off to the back there, up by the fountain. It's gonna be a farm fest, a double kill. Or at least two for the Dire. Shadow Fiend taking one and Gyro taking the other. Bastion now purchased, but I don't think it's gonna be making a difference. Oh, this is risky. Oh, this is actually clever. This is actually quite clever. Just self-fuels when you get into the fountain. And it's going to be doing a tremendous amount of damage. The Witch Doctor Death Ward just does no damage anymore. He's only got 1 point into it. And he's not leveled in a very, very long time. This Witch Doctor. And now the Shadow Fiend has got no Rec Room. He's just going to walk in and die. That's going to be a dieback. He's not going to be there for very, very long. And now maybe the turnaround. They find the Gyro. Maybe. Do they actually catch him? Nope, the Shadow Blade. Silver Edge will be saving him. But still, the middle lane is pushing. And they gotta clean up these creeps, but they don't have the D-push. They don't have anything to clean them up with. Except for the Battle Fury, the Juggernaut. That's about it. But I don't think they can handle the super creeps. It's too early. Death Prophet. He's gonna be wandering out of there. Casually strolling away. Out goes the cooldown. Gyro deciding that he might want to go for something. Nice use of the Ghost Scepter there. By the Death Prophet. And the Gyro just finishing up that PA like it was nothing. He's stunned though. He's going for the Lifestealer. The Damage Wars. Lifestealer might win it. No, he won't. The Rocket Barrage will be finishing the job. Death Prophet still alive. Not anymore. Says goodbye, but only for 16 seconds. And the push is coming in from both the top and the mid. They've got to defend their tier 4s. And Witch Doctor is now the only one actually capable of doing so. But Witch Doctor is not a deep pusher. We can all agree on that. He's going to try to use the Death Ward, but that doesn't bout to creep, my friend. Especially not when there's a Pudge behind you, ready to take you out. Storm Spirit.
Where's the party?
It would be kind of a... It would be very, very sucky if the... if it bounced to creeps, wouldn't it? It's kind of like the Juggernaut Omni Slash, only hitting creeps. Only worse. Oh, the tier 4s, they're so low right now. Spirit Breaker with the jump onto the Juggernaut. Immediate bash does absolutely no damage at all, and he might get cleaned up just too much. The tier 4s are just too much for him. Now the casual stroll in from the Shadow Fiend. How much did it actually turn it around? Not by much, it's still 25 grand. Of difference. Shadow Fiend. He has a nasty Rec Room ready. Not nasty enough though. It's only 18 souls. He needs a tad more for this really to kick ass. They need everybody up as well. Down goes the raises and he gets the pickup. Shadow Fiend self-yules. He doesn't have the Blink Dagger. He has a mech though. Pops that. Gyrocopter with the call down. Connects onto nobody. Oh my, the raise. Just so much damage. What a big nuke. And double kill for the Gyrocopter. I wasn't even expecting that. Oh, there goes the raise though. But now the raise, the Rec Room. A Shadow Fiend will be taking another death. But so will the Storm Spirit, possibly. He's trying for the woods, but not gonna happen. Gyrocopter says absolutely no flipping way. Gets himself a triple kill. And it's now an exposed throne. 31 minutes in.
Something tells me that ancient.
It was fair until minute, somewhat around the 20 minute mark. And then it wasn't fair anymore. Like, this is just painful, actually. 93 kills in 30 minutes. I've never seen anything like it. That is exactly 90 kills a minute. Call down marks the end of an amazing game right there. Wow. I was not expecting that whatsoever. But my gosh, what is a good one? The scoreboard is nuts. I mean, come on. You got 838 experience per minute from a Shadow Fiend. I mean, it's not weird that it's a Shadow Fiend, but it's weird that it's 838. This is dumb. This is insanity. This should not happen in Dota. But I guess the meta is minded towards fighting lineups, and that's exactly what the Radiant pulled off. This is insane. But yeah, I think I'm going to cut it off here. Thank you all so much for watching. Please do check out a video that's going to be going up on Sunday. Remember that, because it's something that everyone is going to have an interest in. And I say that for a reason. It's something I know. Alright? It's something I know everybody's going to have an interest in. It's not something I'm guessing. It's something I know. So, thank you all so much for watching. And thank you for submitting the replay. That was awesome. Weird, but awesome. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.